Today, I'd like to talk about the Ultivar 630 variable speed drive Ethernet communication timeout when using an option card installed on the drive instead of embedded Ethernet port. You can see the Ultivar 630 drive I have has got an embedded Ethernet port, which is in all Ultivar 630s. And then we've also installed a VW3A 3720 option card on this drive. What I'm going to describe also complies with the Ultivar 320, the VW3A 3721 option card as well. It's the same setup for both Ethernet option cards on the Ultivar 630. Under the Ethernet option card, so I am under the settings for the Modbus TCP Ethernet IP option card in slot A. By default, the drive will be in Ethernet IP mode, and you can see that there is no timeout adjustment here. However, if you click to the Modbus TCP settings, there is a holdup time. This is the timeout adjustment for the option card communication channel. Regardless of if you're using Modbus TCP or Ethernet IP on the option card, this is the time for the timeout. So the drive has to see a communication on that channel within this time period, or it will trip and generate an error. To adjust that timeout, you would go to the Modbus TCP settings, make whatever change you wanted to have on the timeout. Then verify, confirm the change by clicking on this checkbox. Once you've done that, that new timeout will be active for both Modbus TCP and Ethernet IP. So you can continue to program the drive if you're using Modbus TCP, or click to the Ethernet IP and make your adjustments there. I do want to point out the note that mentions that the PLC must be stopped before a change is taken into account, and also that the drive has to be restarted after change has been made. If the PLC is already connected to the drive, even if it's not in control, that will prevent the drive's changes from being saved. So you need to stop your PLC or configure it with the PLC not connected. Then once changes are made, you have to reset the drive, which is a to power cycle or a reset through SO move. I'll point out again that the settings for the embedded Ethernet port only apply to the embedded communication port. Changes made to this port don't impact the Modbus TCP option card, and changes made under the option card don't impact the embedded Ethernet port. Once you've made any changes that you want, then you do have to power cycle the drive or reset it. Since I am connected to my drive, I can do the quicker way, and I can select a restart device. This will reboot the CPU without requiring a full power cycle. That can save time when you're working on a very large drive. You don't have to wait for the DC bus to completely bleed off. So you go ahead and say okay, and obviously as the drive reboots, the drive will take a second to reset the CPU, and then my changes will be in effect.